Hi friends, today we are going to see a new topic in which we are going to understand how to implement a multi-rate system which is having a very higher value of either upsampling or downsamplers. For example, if suppose I wanted to upsample or downsample by a factor of 16, okay, then the filter coefficients that I need to calculate is huge. The filter design is huge. Even if I use polyphase filtering, then it will be Z raised to 16 a structure, which is really complicated. To avoid or to actually divide the job and get the things done without increasing the complexity of the design is by using multi-stage implementation. What we are basically doing is, let's say I have my decimation factor, we don't use M, but some books do use M, we use D. So D equals to, let's say, 2, let's say D equals to 16. So we have a decimation of D equals to 16. Then I can factorize 16 as, let's say, D, total D, I can make it as 4 into 2 into 2, or I can write as 8 into 2, or I can make it 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, and so on and so forth. Okay, so here the number of stages that I'm dividing 60 is 16 is 3, here it is 2, and here it is 4, right? So we can reduce huge amount of complexity if I will go with the fourth stage, but then the time delay introduced by each system will also increase. So we need to get an optimum solution when we are dividing the given factor or defactorizing a number. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to factorize a given digit, or let's say a downsampler or an upsampler factor into smaller subfactors, and then I'm going to cascade them. How will my structure look like? Let's say for the first one, I need to have a downsampler of value 4, but I cannot downsample a signal directly. So what I will do is, I will put a filter before it, and then I will sample by a factor of 4. Then I will put second filter, which is H1Z, and then I will put the second downsampler. Finally, the third one, H2Z. It's further down sampled by 2, and now you get the final output, right? So here, if suppose I say fx, right, so here it will be fx only, no change, just limited. Here it will be fx by what? Fx by 4. Then here also it will be fx by 4, no change in the sampling rate. Here it is getting again further increased. So fx by 4 into 2, which is 8. Then here it will be again fx by 8. Finally, we have fx by 8 to the 16. Okay, so this becomes my stage 1. This is my stage 2, and this is my stage 3, right? So
So we have stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. So what I did, I divided the given decimation factor into 3 subsections or subfactors, which is 4, 2, 2. And I achieve, at the final output, I will achieve fx by 16. That is a required sampling rate decrease. So what should be the design procedure for this, or how we should design? So let us first draw an in general block diagram. So in general, if I have a decimation factor d, then I can divide them into products of, okay, let's say I equals to 1 to capital J di, right? Over here, in the first case the J term is 3, in the second case it's 2, and in the third case it is 4. So I can divide it into 1 to J into and it is being product. That's why I've used this pi symbol of di's. Okay, then my in general's block diagram will look like, I will get input as x of n, that will have the first filter, let's say h1 of n, given to the first decimator at stage 1, this will be d1, because the value of I will be equal to 1. Okay, then next will be h2 of n, and the decimator will give me d2, and so on and so forth. It will reach up to, let's say, hj of n, and here the decimation factor will be dj, and then the output here I'll get y of m, let's say. Okay, fine. So here I can say I'm going to get my sampling by d1. Here I'm going to get a sample by d1 d2 multiplication, and here finally I will get fx upon d, where d is nothing but d1 into d2 into d3, so on till dj, which is also written as I is equal to 1 to j di. Okay, so this is how my in general decimation will look like. Now, on what factor does the sampling rate of the ith, let's say any arbitrary stage depends on? I take anyone in between. Okay, let's say at ith stage, okay, what I'm going to achieve at ith stage, my decimated frequency will be equal to f of I minus 1 divided by d of I, and I takes the value as 1, 2, 3, so on till j. What does it mean? If suppose I'm standing at stage number 2, on what basis stage number 2 depends on? Let's say this I write to be as f1. Okay, so f1 is complete, fx by d1. What will be output at d2? The output at d2 will be f2, let's say, at stage 2, which depends on f1 upon d2. Correct? So here the value of I is equal to 2. That's why I'm going to get d2 and f2, and here it is 1. 1 means it is less than 2. How much less? 1 less than 2. So the next sampling rate depends on the previous stage sampling rate. That's why in general we have written it as fi is equal to fi minus 1 upon di, right? And where I depends on 1 to j. Now, in the initial stage, that is at the first stage, where I'm going to get xn, I represent that the xn, let's say, signal is sampled at a rate of fx, which is the 0th, let's say, zeroth frequency. So f naught is equal to fx is equal to fx. This is at the zeroth stage, that is at the input stage. Okay, then to avoid the process of aliasing, okay, what I should have, a total decimation process should be like, if I'm dividing it by 16, then my filter should reduce the band of the input signal in such a way that when it is going to get spreaded, it will spread up to pi. It will not go beyond. This will avoid my aliasing. So the overall, to manage the overall aliasing, okay, what we will do is we will control aliasing at each stage. Because if I am controlled aliasing at stage 1, this signal is going to get processed by signal stage 2. Stage 2 also, I'll put a filter such a way that it will also take care that there will be no aliasing. And if each stage take care of there is no aliasing, then when I'm going to generate the output, the final stage will not have any sort of aliasing. Okay, so to avoid aliasing, I need to design each filter very carefully. So what are the design equations for each stage that we will write? Okay, so for filter at each stage, okay, I will have my pass band to be equal to going from 0 to F to FPC. Okay, and my transition band to be between FPC less than equal to F less than equal to FSC. Okay, and FSC is equal to FX less than equal to FX by 2 into D. Okay, so my transition, my passband should be 0 to FPC, transition should be FPC to FSC, and FSC should not exceed FX by 2D. If this happens, if FSC does not exceed FX by 2D, then what is going to happen? There will not be any aliasing. Otherwise, there will be aliasing. Okay, now next we have, okay, at each stage, this will take care now. Okay, so for each stage, okay, to avoid aliasing, what I will have is my at each stage, I will have pass band to be 0 less than equal to F less than equal to FPC. Okay, then my transition band to be between FPC less than equal to F less than equal to FI minus FSC. Okay, FI is the previous is the current state in which we are, and stop band should be from FI minus FSC less than equal to F less than equal to FI minus FSC. Oh, it will not be FI. This two limits are the same, so it will not go up to that point, but it should be I minus 1 upon 2, where I minus 1 is in the index. Okay, so it will go from FI minus FSC to FI minus 1 upon 2. Why this is so? Because I need to take care that my stop band should be less than or equal to FX by 2D. To maintain this situation, I will use this condition. Okay, so what will be at stage 1? Let's say at the first stage itself. Okay, so at stage 1, okay, What is the value of I over here? I is equal to 1. So what will be I minus 1? I minus 1 will be 0. Okay. What will be passband in that case? Passband will be 0 less than equal to F less than equal to FPC, whatever given in the problem. Transition band will be nothing but, what it will be? FPC given less than equal to F less than equal to F of 0 minus FSC. Correct? And what is F of 0? Sorry, FI. So it is FI. So if it is I is 1. So FI is F1 minus FSC. And stop band will be F1 minus FSC less than equal to F less than equal to F1 minus F0 by 2. Okay. And what is F0? F0 is equal to FX. Right. So this is at stage 1. In this way, if I am dividing into 3 stages, my I is going to take value from 1, 2, 3. If I am going to divide into 4 stages, then it will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So this same step will repeat 4 times. Okay. So this you have to take care while designing a decimator section or using multi-stage implementation. This will actually reduce the burden of the system, or system complexity will really be reduced. How it will reduce? That we will check using a problem, that we will actually experience using a problem. But just for now, just to understand how it will reduce is to, because the filter is been now been designed at lower impulse or lower value of frequency, what is going to happen is I can actually have trade off, okay, between the required components in a given filter, okay, to give the same response. Also, because I'm working with lower and lower number of components, the order of the filter required will also be less. So if I am implementing a one stage higher value of decimator, then the required filter order will be very high. Whereas if I'm working with a multi-stage, then each filter will be, ultimately the cascade will give you that value, but each filter will have a lower order, and that really improves the computation complexity of the filter. Okay, so I hope that this much explanation is enough to understand why we actually require a multi-stage implementation of a sampling rate converter. The very important piece of information that you need to always keep in mind while understanding or learning this multi-stage is the set of formulas that I have written over here. These are the set of formulas that you should never forget, because there will be huge amount of design problems that will be arising on this set of formulas. Okay. I hope you have understood what you mean by multi-stage implementation of sampling rate converters. Thank you.